Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera students. So today I'll be explaining about the business e-portfolio report. Basically this is the assignment for a group, for your group assignment, for your presentation and also written report. Basically this report is about your experience handling a digital business throughout from week 5 until the week 10, which is remember APK Virtual Expo. So that was the last week for you to do your business, digital business. Okay, so let's go on. So here, business e-portfolio report is actually your reflection about your business. So this report is the report after doing your business. It's an assessment to look at your experience doing your business. So it's divided into two, which is the first one, you have to present your business e-portfolio report. So we will assume that your presentation is a presentation of the draft of your business e-portfolio report. So here, when you present, it could be a live presentation or a pre-recorded video with a maximum 15 minutes video or 15 minutes live presentation. So here, if you are doing live presentation, please do the presentation according to your section's time or according to your lecturer's assumed time. Okay, and the next one, if you are doing pre-recorded video, please upload your video on the YouTube channel and provide the link to your lecture. Please ensure that the YouTube video is assigned to unlisted or for public. Okay, if you list that video in private settings, the lecturer will not be able to see your presentation. Okay guys, so let's go to the written business e-portfolio final report. After your lecturer have looked at your presentation, or you can do this in between after your presentation or before your presentation, you can do this written business report on a website. Okay, remember when you did the exercise in week 7 to do a website on your Wix, Google site, or Weebly or WordPress. Okay, so please use this experience from doing that exercise, doing a website, and apply it in doing this written business e-portfolio report. So please create a website that is easy for you to use as a group, okay? And please upload or write your report on that website rather than doing your report or write your report on a Word document, okay? Why not use the website to elaborate, to write up your experience more elaboratively in an essay form on the website, okay? So we will assume the most important thing is to reflect, show your reflexivity about your business on this website. We will not assess the creativity behind you doing the website. However, we will appreciate your effort in doing a very nice look website, okay? So here, the length of the written report will be presented or will be elaborated more afterwards. Okay, here, if you see your course outline, which was given in the first week of APK lecture, or you can see this, find this course outline in the WhatsApp group, in your WhatsApp group, in the Telegram group, or in the Smart V3 UMS. Here, this course outline has outlined the guideline on how to do this business e-portfolio report, especially for your presentation and also for your final written report. So here, if you can see here, the presentation and also written report for the business e-portfolio has or is or have the same content for the presentation and written report, okay? So you can see here, whatever that you present during your presentation, it is the same content that you will use to write the report, which you will need to submit at the end of week 14. So here, business e-portfolio should include the first one, explain to us about your business. Second thing about your company, who is in your company, how did you promote your business, what was your company's or your group's achievement, your sales and profit, so you can use your financial statement which you have learned in Unit 7 here. You can use the income statement, balance sheet, and also your cash flow. Later on, we would like to see your reflexibility about what were the problems that you faced during the business. So here, please state out, be truthful here. What kind of problems did you face as a group doing this business? Okay, perhaps your problem within the communication with your group, doing this business, in terms of products, business performance, in terms of your skills, in terms of your sales, in terms of your knowledge. Okay, please be truthful here. And what were the solutions that you implemented to solve the problems you faced throughout doing this digital business? Okay, remember you did this digital business from week 5 until week 10. So what did you do to solve that kind of problem you mentioned just now? Here, after telling us the solution that you tell us, what were the recommendations that you could think of that you can implement in the future if those kind of problems will occur, or other kind of recommendations that you can think of to improve your business in the future, and then put in your appendix. Okay, so let's go on one by one. I'll be elaborating it more here on how to do this business e-portfolio report on your website. Okay, first thing, I will suggest my students to categorize their report based on certain sections here or in subsections. Okay, like the content that I elaborated just now, here you can create different tabs, or you can call it pages. When you create that website, create different pages or tabs to show that categorization of your report. For example, introduction of your business, what is your business practicum type, what is your industry, what are the products or services that you are selling, and then about us, about your company achievement, and then your sales and profit, the problems and the solutions that you implemented, and your suggestions for the future, and the appendix as your proof to show that you did your business throughout week 5 until week 10. Okay, so let's go on to the introduction part. So here you can elaborate more what is about your business, what is your business, what industry you are in, what type of business practicum did you choose when you first presented your BMC, whether business practicum of order and deliver, gig economy, SULAM, or even event management. Okay, so after you elaborate more about yourself, here I will advise my students to look at your BMC report back. You can also use that as an inspiration to write up this introduction part. Okay, so here about us, you can elaborate more about your business practicum, industry, product or services, who is in your company. So I will assume that you have presented this idea, this information, and it will maintain the same as you presented in the BMC. And you can just use your BMC report to inspire you to do this section. But however, if you have made adjustment from the BMC report, it did not state as you presented before, you have made changes to your business, to your company, to your group, please improve or update the report in this business e-portfolio report. Okay, so please, this one, the introduction part and about us part, or who is in your company part, will be a section where the lecturer will refresh your mind, or reflect back what is your company doing. Okay, remind them back what you are doing. All right, so here the next one is the promotion part. How did you promote your business, or if you're doing SULAM, how do you promote your local businesses you're helping? Okay, so here look at the channels that you use, whether you use traditional channels, for example face-to-face, opening up a stall, or digital channels, for example social media channels, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, or other digital channels like email, like website. Okay, please tell us how did you use this channels. Okay, I will tell you one by one how you can do this part or elaborate more on this part. The first thing, when you say you are using Instagram to promote your business, so what is the handle name, the username of the Instagram part, Instagram account that you are using? So here, if you have different Instagram accounts to under your group, for example, you are using your group's main Instagram account and you have also your personal account to do your promotion of your business, or also you have other subsidiaries Instagram account to do the promotion of your business, okay, please let us know. All right, be transparent when you do this report. Tell us more, how did you do the promotion for this business practicum, okay? What channels did you use? So when you say these channels that I use to promote my business, for example, I use Instagram to promote my business. So why did you use Instagram account to promote your business? So here it could reflect back, for example, I use Instagram account because it is where most of my target markets are, because my target market, as I explained earlier in week 4 in BMC report, is that I use, for example, Generation Z. I'm aiming those people, okay? So tell me more, why did you use these channels? What was your customer segmentation? So does your account are relevant to your target segment, okay? So the next is, how did you use these channels, the digital channels or traditional channels? How did you use these channels? For example, if I'm using Instagram account to target the Generation Z, how did I use this Instagram account is by posting interactive posts on Instagram account to be consistent with my posting, because I post every day. So I will tell more about how did I do my promotions on Instagram, whether I use, this will reflect back to the strategies post I do on these channels, okay? I will say that, for example, you can say whether I use soft selling, hard selling posts to promote my business, my products or services on Instagram. You can also mention about the media that you use. I use videos and also photos. So if I use this, I could also reflect back, I use photos, videos more because I could see that people are more interactive on my videos as compared to my pictures. So please be reflective about what you did on your Instagram or other channels too when you do your promotion. Here it will trigger your critical thinking to see what works, what did not work. So here you can also say in your promotion part, saying what works and what didn't work. Okay, so it will help you to build that critical thinking, to be reflective and then be constructive in doing this promotion. In the future, you'll reflect back what works and what didn't work to improve your business more, okay? So, and tell me, when did you use these channels? Whether you use it every day, whether you use it once in a week, alright? Twice in a week, tell me. And then the next one is the proof to show that you indeed use these channels that you mentioned. If you say you are using Instagram, please show proof that you are using Instagram. If you said that you are posting videos and photos, please show proof that you are posting videos and photos. If you're using stories, reels, if you're using WhatsApp status, you're using WhatsApp for business, you're using Facebook page and you're promoting on your personal account on Instagram or Facebook or WhatsApp, okay, with your friends and family, please provide a screenshot to tell us you indeed use these channels, and here are my proof, okay? So here the proof will act as a to justify the things that you mentioned, and it will help the lecturer to be confident that you were doing this business, okay? All right, if especially when you did participated in the APK virtual expo and you did the FB live, please provide the proof, okay? The FB live screenshot, how many engage on your FB live. Perhaps you can also be reflective in terms of whether the FB live did generate more sales or more orders as compared when you did other types of promotion on other channels, okay? Where did you get more sales? You can be reflective in terms of that also. Where did you get more sales? On Instagram, on Facebook, okay? So please be sure here. Perhaps you can say on WhatsApp also, alright? Okay, next, these are the examples, okay? You can reflect back to your customer segmentation and also the type of post that you use. And here is the most important thing, to ensure the lecturer that you did do your business, to post or to share the screenshots of your insights, to show that you did use Instagram for business account and also FB page. Here, please provide a screenshot of your insights. Okay, so you can just click on the Instagram insights and FB insights and provide the proof of it. But whatever you provide a proof or a screenshot here, comment on that screenshot. What do you understand about those data that you share? Okay. Okay, so here is the achievement part. Achievement is very subjective here. It depends on your group what you determine as achievement. It could be in terms of business performance, for example, your total sales, the numbers of followers, whether you have achieved your vision that you mentioned in week 4 or week 5, okay? The vision, objective, or goals, mission, okay? And also, you can show the achievement in terms of sales, whether you achieved the targeted sales, whether you have improved customer satisfaction, achieved customer satisfaction, whether you have handled a negative customer comment, that is an achievement, okay? Handling a negative customer feedback is an achievement for a company, okay? And in turning that negative comment into a customer that is satisfied with your feedback is an achievement, okay? The next thing is you can also share about the feedback. If you're doing sulang, the feedback of your local business, okay? Please share a feedback from their perspective. Perhaps you can ask them to take a video of themselves giving a feedback, live feedback or comments about your service to their company, to their local business, okay? And then achievement, you can also determine in terms of skills and knowledge that you gain from doing this digital business, okay? The next thing is the profit part. The profit, sales or profit here, you can reflect this sales and profit by showing and then commenting also, okay? Showing your income statement, it will show your profit, your sales, the total cost, your balance sheet, and also your cash flow, okay? If you want to do the break-even point also, that will be appreciated. And then the next one, if you have registered on Go E-commerce, the screenshot of you doing the sales report on Go E-commerce can be as proof that you have participated in doing or registering in Go E-commerce as well, okay? So here, when you show the report, your financial statements here, don't leave it like that. Please give a brief comment here. What do you understand from this income statement? It shows the net profit, blah, 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 blah. It means we did not incur any loss, okay, for example. Right, the next one is your problems and the solutions. Remember when I said about problems? Problems are the things that you faced during week 5 until week 10 when you were doing this business, okay? What kind of problems did you face? Be truthful here. You can also reflect on the threats or the weakness that happened to your company. Be truthful here. For example, it could be related to your business performance. Perhaps you face losses, okay? Perhaps too much costs, all right? You did not handle your cash flow very well. Perhaps there was a problem with your teamwork. Perhaps there's a lack of skills in certain areas. Perhaps there's a lack of knowledge in certain areas. Be truthful here. We want to see your reflection from doing this digital business. Be transparent here, okay? Because we learn from our mistakes, remember? Okay, so here, when you face that kind of problems that you mentioned just now, what were the solutions you implemented to solve the problem? Did you implement a solution to solve that problem? Did you do or not? Okay, please tell us you solved the problem or not. Okay, so here you can categorize or organize this section when you're doing the written report. You can organize this section. For example, you lay out the risk, the first risk, and then what were the solutions, and then the second risk, elaborate on it, and then what were the solutions and the elaboration. And then the next part is that the other ways to categorize it or organize it is by saying all the risks that you face, elaborate on it, and then what were the solutions that you implemented, and elaborate on it. Okay, and then the next one is what are your suggestions to improve your business? Okay, perhaps the solutions you implemented to solve the problems you faced just now was not satisfactory. Perhaps you thought that, hey, there are other ways I can solve this problem. So I could solve the problem by doing other things. So it could be a suggestion that you can use in the future when you are doing a digital business. Okay, the other way you can think about suggestion is that what are the things that you can improve more to improve more of your business. Okay, so think about it and be constructive here. Okay, all right. Okay, the next and the last one is your appendix. So appendix is the proof that will help you justify that you really did this business. Okay. For example, the screenshots of your social media platforms, your insights, your feedbacks, your postings, your local businesses feedback, and etc. Okay, it is up to you. You can show the photos of your products or your services. Okay, your proof of photo that you are delivering the product to your customers. Those are worthy photos to be included in your appendix. Okay, the next one is, please remember, when you do this business e-portfolio, it is based on your experience in conducting the digital business. Okay, please show your reflection in this report and your presentation. So when you do your presentation, it will be in week 13. Okay, whether you're doing a live or pre-recorded video here. So it is most important when the lecturer will look at your presentation here and give a feedback, what things that you could think of more, what you can improve in your presentation or even in your written feedback, which you need to submit in the next week, okay, in week 14. All right, so this feedback, it could be in terms of questions also, which you need to answer, and also the suggestions from your lecturer. So please, it is up to you whether you want to use this feedback, the questions, and also the recommendations from your lecturer to improve more of your written report before you submit the final report. Okay, the next one is your written report. So here you can use different types of websites, development software or platform. For example, Wix, Google Site, WordPress, Weebly, what other things you can think of? Blogger, okay? It is up to you to decide as a group which platform you will use to do your written report, okay? I will strongly recommend the group to do or to use Google Site because it is very easy and it's very straightforward. Okay, and also here, please bear in mind when you create the website, you can use your UMS Edu email, okay, to create the Google Site, for example. Please make sure you click publish before you share the link with your lecturer. If you did not click publish, the lecturer will not be able to see your website because it is not published yet, and the lecturer will not be and when you are not publishing that website, it will not be seen to the public. Okay, All right, so here, that's it. Good luck, everybody. Bye.